Hello students, how are you? I hope you will be fine, happy and safe. Okay, in the previous lecture we have started three visions for India 2.4 lesson, you know that, and we have completed page number 440 and we are on page number 41 and we have completed I think first paragraph. Okay, so I will repeat for you. Page number 41, first paragraph. India must stand up to the world, means India must brave, India must become brave, and India must face challenges to the world. Okay, I have a third vision that India must stand up to the world or no one will respect us. If you are not brave, or if we will be not brave, if India will not face the challenges, no one will respect India, Indian people. Only strength respects strength. Okay, strength respect strength. Strength is respected by strength. We must be strong, not only as a military power, but also as an economic power. Both must go hand in hand. So military power as well as economic power, both powers must go hand in hand. Both powers are very important and crucial for us. Next paragraph. Why are we in India so embarrassed to recognize our own strength, our own achievements? India has great achievements. India has his own great strength. But why do we feel ashamed, embarrassed? Embarrassed means feeling ashamed. So why do we feel ashamed to recognize our own power? Strength means power, our own achievements. We are such a great nation. India ek bahut great nation hai. We have so many amazing success stories, but we refuse to acknowledge them. Why? Why we do not acknowledge, or why we refuse to acknowledge our success story? We are the second largest producer of wheat in the world. We are the second largest producer of rice. We are the first in milk production. We are number one in remote sensing satellites. Okay, look at Dr. Sudarshan. He has transferred the tribal village into self-sustaining. Self-sustaining means self-providing, providing for one's need. Okay, self-dependent you can say. So Mr. Sudarshan, Dr. Sudarshan transferred tribal village, means very poor villages, Adivasi villages, into self-developed, self-dependent, self-driving, self-controlled villages. There are millions of such achievements, but our media is obsessed only with bad news and failures and disasters. There are millions of success stories of India. There are millions of achievements of India, but our media, you know, social media and print media, electronic media, media like Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, Twitter, and print media means newspaper, and electronic media means TV channels, they are obsessed means they are covered, they only cover bad news. Bad news India ke bare mein hamari media only bad news ko hi dikhati hai. Good news ko dikhati nahi. Bad news and failures and disasters. Disasters means calamities. India के ऊपर जो calamity, जो संकट आता है, जो bad news India के बारे में कुछ होती रहती है, bad घटनाएं, तो उन्हीं घटनाओं को या disasters को दिखाने का काम हमारा media करता है, बस बाकी कुछ नहीं. Okay? Next. Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? Why don't we realize this thing? Why don't we realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? If we are self-dependent, if we are not dependent on anyone, other people will respect us. Why don't we realize? I was in Tel Aviv once and I was reading the Israeli newspaper. Dr. Kalam was in Tel Aviv. Tel Aviv is the name of the city of Israel. Israel country, you know, very developed and advanced country, Israel. So Dr. Kalam was in Israel and he was reading Israeli newspaper. It was the day after a lot of attacks and bombardments and deaths had taken place. Okay, it was lot of attacks. So Israel had faced lot of attacks and bombardments, bomb attacks the Israel's country had faced, and deaths had been taken place in Israel. So it was the next day. It was the next day of that attack. मतलब जिस दिन अटैक हुआ था बहुत सारे डेथ हो गए थे, बॉम्ब अटैक हो गए थे, बम्बार्डमेंट्स मींस बॉम्ब अटैक हो गए थे, इजराइल को पूरी तरह मतलब डिस्ट्रॉय करने की कोशिश की गई थी. उसका नेक्स्ट डे जो न्यूज़पेपर था, दैट न्यूज़पेपर ही वाज रीडिंग. ओके, डॉक्टर कलाम वाज रीडिंग. द हम्स हैड स्ट्रक but the front page of the newspaper had the picture of Jewish gentleman who in 5 years had transformed his desert land into an orchard farm and granary. The Hamas had struck. Hamas is the name of city. City had struck with bombardments, but on the front page of Israeli newspaper there was a picture of Jewish gentleman. Jew, J-E-W. Jew is a kind of community like that Christian. Christian is a kind of community like that. Jew is the kind of community, and there was a picture of Jewish gentleman. That gentleman had transformed his desert land. That Jewish gentleman had converted his desert land into orchard farm and granary. उसकी जो desert land थी, रेगिस्तान जैसी उसकी जमीन थी, उसको उस gentleman ने orchard farm में convert किया था. Orchard, you know that orchard is name of the flower. Orchard flowers and granary. तो वहाँ crops उसने उगाए थे, फूल को उगाया था. एक रेगिस्तान बंजर जमीन को उसने एक फर्टाइल लैंड में कन्वर्ट किया था. वहां ऑर्चर्ड एंड ग्रेनरी क्रॉप्स लिए थे. ओके, और फ्रंट पेज पे उस जेंटलमैन का पिक्चर था. मतलब जिस दिन उसके पहले दिन इजराइल पर इतना बड़ा संकट आया था, इतने सारे डेथ्स हो गए थे, उसके बाद भी उसका कोई भी मेंशनिंग फ्रंट पेज पर नहीं था. It was this inspiring picture that everyone woke up to. The picture of that gentleman was inspiring for all Israeli people to start their day. The gory details of killings, bombardments and deaths were inside the newspaper, buried among other news. The gory, what is the gory? G-O-R-Y, gory means involving bloodshed and violence. News involving bloodshed and violence. Bloodshed मतलब बोलते हैं ना खून बहाने की जो ये घटना थी, या violence. So ये violence और खून भरी घटनाएं, details of killings, bombardments and news, all deaths, all these kinds of news, bad news, bloodshed news, violence news were covered inside the newspaper and were buried among the other news. These news were hid among the other news. These news were not highlighted on any page, not front page or any page. These news were not highlighting news, not important news, main news. Okay, isn't it possible in our country? क्या हमारी कंट्री में ये पॉसिबल नहीं है? लेकिन हमारा मीडिया जो है, वो हमारा मीडिया सिर्फ और सिर्फ और सिर्फ भारत के बारे में बुरी खबरों को ही छापता है या दिखाता है. So we have to learn lesson from Israel. Okay, next paragraph. I want to live in a developed India. Another question. Why are we as a nation so obsessed with foreign things? as a nation, as Indian people, as country, why we are covered with foreign things? Why we like foreign things very much? Rekhane, apela khub foreign things avadta. So why we obsess, why we covered with foreign things? We want foreign TVs, we want foreign shirts, we want foreign technology, we want foreign vehicle, we want foreign cars, we want everything which is made in Western countries. We do not like the production of India. We do not like the things which is made, which is produced in India. Why we are obsess or why we want such a foreign things? Why this obsession with everything imported? Why this obsession? Obsession with everything. Okay? Why we want the things which is imported things? हमें imported things पहनने में या imported things use करने में बहुत एक proud feel करते हैं. क्यों? हम क्यों Indian things के बारे में proud feel नहीं करते? हमारा India भी बहुत सारी अच्छी चीजें produce करता है, production होता है, but we do not feel proud about Indian things. So why do we feel proud about imported things, Western things, the things which is produced, which is made in Western countries? Dr. Kalam asked this. Why this obsession of everything imported? Do we not realize that self-respect comes with self-reliance? अगर हम self-reliant है, अगर हम self-dependent है, अगर हम इंडिया में ही बहुत सारा production बना सकते हैं, then why are we dependent on other countries? Okay? Self-reliance, self-respect comes with self-reliance. We must realize these things. Means we should not depend on other countries or we should not feel proud to use the foreign things. Keep in mind, I was in Hyderabad giving this lecture when a 14-year-old girl asked me for my autograph. In Hyderabad, a 14-year-old girl asked autograph to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam when he was giving lecture. I asked her what her goal in life is. So Dr. Kalam asked that girl what was her goal or what her goal was. She replied, I want to live in a developed India. The girl gave a beautiful answer, beautiful reply, that she wanted to live in a developed India, means she wanted a developed nation. Still we are a developing nation. We have not become developed nation, and the next generation wants to live in developed India. For her, you and I will have to build this developed India. You must proclaim for everyone. Okay, for you, for we, for us, for everyone, for next generation, we have to build our country a developed nation. We have to make India developed India. You must proclaim. You must proclaim. Proclaim meaning is given there. Proclaim means declare confidently to all. We must declare confidently to all people in India that India must become developed nation for all of us, for next generation, for us, for you and for me. India must become developed nation, Dr. Kalam ne kaha hai. Okay, so in this way, on page number 41, we have completed this lesson, 3 visions for India. Very easy lesson it is. I hope you have understood the lesson. Okay, so see on page number 42. Okay, but before learning 42 page, there are some questions. Okay, there are some questions on page number 40 and page number 41 beside the lesson. Just like first question, what helped Dr. Kalam fix this 3 visions for India? The answer is in first paragraph. Okay, means the achievements and the progress that India has witnessed in the history of the nation and during his own career as a missile scientist helped Dr. Kalam fix the 3 visions for India. The answer is in first paragraph. Okay, second question, how should we handle our freedom? How should we handle our freedom? We should handle our freedom. I think the answer is in page number 40, paragraph number 3. So we must protect and nurture and build our freedom. Okay, so there are some simple questions that we can solve easily on page number 40 and page number 41. Okay, I hope you have understood the lesson and the question answers. The next part we will learn in the next lecture. Thank you.